Preface. Idam hi pumsas tapasa shrutasya va shvishdasya suktasya cha buddhi dateo avichuto rita kavibir nirupito yad uttama shloka gunanu varnanam. Translation. Learned sages have definitely concluded that the infallible fruit of knowledge, austerity, Vedic study, sacrifice, the chanting of hymns, and charity is found in the transcendental descriptions of the qualities of the Lord, who is defined in choice poetry. Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 5th Chapter, Verse 22. Purport. The human intellect is developed for advancement in art, science, philosophy, physics, chemistry, psychology, economics, politics, and other fields. Through the culture of knowledge, humanity can attain the perfection of life, which culminates in the realization of the Supreme Being Vishnu. The Shruti therefore advises the learned to aspire for the service of Lord Vishnu. Unfortunately, when people are enamored by the external beauty of Vishnu Maya, they do not understand that perfection or self-realization depends on Vishnu. Vishnu Maya means sense enjoyment, which is transient and miserable. Those who are entrapped by Vishnu Maya utilize their knowledge for sense enjoyment. Sri Narada Muni, however, has explained that all phenomena in the universe emanate from the Lord, because the Lord, through his inconceivable energies, has set in motion the actions and reactions of the creation. Everything has come into being out of his energy. Everything rests on his energy. And after annihilation, everything merges into him. Therefore, nothing is different from the Lord, although the Lord is always different from his creation. When knowledge is applied in the service of the Lord, the process of advancement becomes absolute. The Supreme Personality of Godhead and His transcendental name, fame, and glory are all non-different from Him. Therefore, all sages and devotees of the Lord have recommended that art, science, philosophy, physics, chemistry, psychology, and other branches of knowledge be wholly and solely applied in the Lord's service. Art, literature, poetry, and music may be used in glorifying the Lord. Poets and other celebrated literateurs are generally engaged in writing of sensuous themes. But if they turn towards the service of the Lord, they can describe the Lord's transcendental pastimes. Valmiki was a great poet, and Vyasadeva was a great writer, and both completely engaged themselves in delineating the transcendental activities of the Lord, and by so doing, they have become immortal. Similarly, science and philosophy should also be applied in the service of the Lord. Advanced people are eager to understand the absolute truth through the medium of science, and therefore scientists should endeavor to prove the Lord's existence on a scientific basis. Philosophy should also aim to establish the supreme truth as sentient and all-powerful. Indeed, all other branches of knowledge should similarly be engaged in the Lord's service. This is also affirmed by Bhagavad Gita. All knowledge not engaged in the Lord's service is but nescience. Advanced knowledge should be utilized to establish the glories of the Lord, and that is the real import of this verse. Scientific knowledge and other branches of knowledge engaged in the Lord's service are all factually Hari Kirtan, glorification of the Lord.